Folks, I know there's some times that I've preached my heart out in this pulpit over the years. And I've known that there were some that needed to hear the message and they didn't hear it at all. They knew that I was under prophetic anointing of the Holy Ghost. They knew that the word was coming straight, unadulterated. They knew it was like fire from heaven, like the hammer. It was the Holy Ghost. David Wilkerson was out of the picture. The Spirit of God was on me. And I know there are times that there were some that were so angry, they didn't receive it. They walked right out, or they saw me sometime, and they had that hard, cold face. It didn't touch them. They just, that's not for me. And it was for them. They didn't receive it. They walked out, and many of them are not here anymore. But let me tell you, this man is different. This man says, Peter, pray ye to the Lord for me, that none of these things which you've spoken come upon me. Simon had respect for spiritual authority. He had respect for this man of God. He said, you are a man of truth. He said, I know your words are true. Pray that this doesn't happen to me. Pray that it doesn't happen to me. I know there's some people that God has made me a prophet to. And I know many don't listen. But one day they will. One day they will. Everything that said will come to pass. And you're hearing the word of God tonight. You know what the Holy Spirit's after? He's after you to lay this down. Whatever's in your heart, make things right. Get it out so that there's nothing standing between you. What do you do now with this? After you've heard this, the distinguishing marks of a work of iniquity. Now, what do you do when, if you stand before Jesus tonight? If your life is suddenly taken and you stand before Jesus, what are you going to do having heard the message? You were clearly described all the marks of a work of iniquity, and yet you did nothing about it. I'm going to ask you, because I'm a pastor who cares. I beg of you in the name of Jesus, don't carry out of this church tonight any ill will, any bitterness. I don't care who it's against, how long it's been there. It's got to go. You bring it to Jesus tonight. He will heal you. He'll bless you. He'll restore to you all the years the cankerworm has eaten. And you'll stand before him on that day. And he'll reach out, embrace you, pull you to his breast, and say, well done. Well done, good and faithful servant. Are you a worker of iniquity? Will you stand? Now, folks, I've only preached about 35 minutes. Not been long, but you've got the point. I'm going to open the altars. I'd expect you to shout. Up in the balcony. Here in the main floor. Holy Ghost, turn the searchlight on. Lord, if there's anything in our hearts, we've got to get it out. It's got to be confessed and left at this altar. We can't go out this church tonight. We have to humble ourselves and acknowledge it before you. Oh, God. Holy Spirit, reach out in love. Reach out. Find it, Lord. Search it out. Bring it out, Lord. Get out of your seat quickly. Up in the balcony. Go to the stairs on either side and come. Wherever you're at. But obey the Holy Spirit. Don't like to turn the whole church, from the choir, all through here, all of us. Let's examine our hearts before the Lord right now. Say, oh God, search me, try me, see if there be any wicked way in me. And it doesn't mean you have to live under self-examination all the time. But when the word comes to search us out, it's time to obey him. Hallelujah. Will you pray this prayer with me now from the depths of your heart? And I mean lift it out to the Lord. Jesus, I ask you to forgive me for all bitterness, for everything spoken out of my tongue and mouth that was displeasing to you. Sanctify my mouth. Cleanse my tongue. Give me a pure heart. Forgive me and cleanse me. I repent, Lord, of grieving you, of sinning against you. I need conviction, Lord. I need a new heart. Cleanse me wholly, completely. Thank you, Jesus, that you can take my bitterness, take it out, destroy it, and replace it with love and forgiveness. Lord, I do forgive those who've sinned against me, that I may be forgiven of my Heavenly Father. Now I'm going to pray for you, and I want you to believe God with me right now. Holy Spirit, I'm not the searcher of hearts, but you certainly are. You're able to probe deep. Your eye penetrates to the very core of our heart, our mind and soul. Lord Jesus, show those that are in this church tonight anything that must be made right. God, let it be made right. Lord, the least that has to be done tonight is to get it out of the spirit, to get it out of the heart, that none of these things affect our spirit, that our spirits are kept pure and clean before you. Oh God, deal with all the lust and the problems of our flesh. We come to you, Lord, knowing that the blood does cleanse, that there's forgiveness, there's healing, there's restoration. Hallelujah. We can be restored in you, Lord. I want everybody that believes the Lord has heard you and forgiven you, raise your hands and thank the Lord right now. Lord, I give you thanks.
This is the conclusion of the message.